Hi, this is Adam Gusso from Satan and Adam, and we're going to continue our series of lessons now. When I left off last time, I was talking about single notes and how important it is to do the two-hole draw. When I listen to harp players, including players that, in bands, if there's one thing that most of them fail on, it's that for some reason they've neglected to learn how to do a strong, clear two-hole draw. They'll play circles around me, but then they'll come right back down to home plate, which is that two-hole draw, that tonic note, and it just won't be very strong, or it'll be flat. Maybe the harp's flat, maybe their embouchure's wrong. So here again, diagnostic. If your tone sounds like that, you're doing okay. If it sounds like this, where you're getting a little bit of the one hole, a little bit of the three hole, that's a problem. If it sounds weak, that's a problem. And in all these cases, the solution is one that, again, I have to thank John Gindick for this, but the solution is you got to make your lips fat. Right? Not old maid's mouth, not, but, okay. And you want to do that with no vibrato. And here's a way. So what I want you to do is I want you to tap your foot, and I want you to, for seven beats, I want you to play the clearest, loudest two-hole draw that you can. And on the eighth beat, you're going to let the harp move away from your lips just a little bit, and you're going to breathe out through it and around it. It's going to sound like this. I'm going to tap my hand instead, so you'll hear that sound. Now what you'll discover, of course, is that after about four of those, first of all, your hand or your foot's getting tired. You're getting a little hyperventilated. You're feeling that sweet sickness that you get when you're hyperventilated. But what will begin to happen if you do this, every time you pick up the harp, do this. Play four bars. One, two, three, four, eight bars, right? And get all of the air that you drew in to go out on that eighth bar. And each time you come back, I want that good, tight, solid embouchure with the harp pushing between your lips. That's the way to get a really good sound. All right. It's time to talk about vibrato. Because vibrato is really where the harmonica is. If you're talking about tone and the difference between a player who's okay and a player who makes you want to just sit there and really soak it up, I think the difference is vibrato. When I was learning how to play, I remember the first lesson I had with my teacher, Nat Riddles. I was doing vibrato the way that I had figured out to do it from the records. And I think it was taken from Paul Butterfield, but this is what I would do. This is a B-flat harp, and I would take the two-hole draw, and I would kind of cough inwardly. Now, we all made that sound, right? Okay, so what you're doing there is your hands are, your epiglottal stop, your glottis in here is kind of actually hitting itself. It's flesh against flesh, it's cartilage against cartilage. That's not an efficient way to produce vibrato. I remember early on, I was mystified. Is it throat vibrato or is it gut vibrato, belly vibrato? You know, you're moving the harp. What are you doing? This was a big thing for me at a certain point in my career. And then my teacher, Nat, he did this. And he raised his chin. And he could slow it down. He could speed it up. If he was tapping his foot, the speed of the vibrato seemed to have something to do with how fast or slow the groove was. And so what's going on? What's the difference between what I was doing at the age of 28 and what I'm doing now? Well, obviously one thing is make sure you've got the good, clear, single note, two-hole draw with no vibrato first. If you can't do that, you can't do vibrato. The second thing is, understand that what you're going for isn't this, it's this. All right? What Nat was doing, what I'm able to do now, what the better players are able to do, is to get a vibrato that's really controlled, that can go at a low volume. Excuse me, that can go at a low volume as well as a high volume. So Butterfield had the great high volume thing, but not always with the low volume. So I want perfect control from you, right? Okay, it's even more important when you're playing in my... Come on, shut up, Ant. It's more important when you're playing amplified. From to, this is what I did. I decided that I was going to take whatever vibrato I had, whatever vibrato I was capable of producing, and I was going to do it for 7 beats, like we did on the two-hole draw with no vibrato. And I was going to tap my foot, and I was going to just do whatever vibrato I could do for 7 beats. And I was going to take that big out-breath on the 8th beat, and I was going to do it again. In other words, I was going to do what meditators do when you come up against who you are and what you are, and you sit with it. You just confront exactly where you are. You don't try to hide from it. You just say, I'm going to do what I do, but then I'm going to work on it. And so what begins to happen when you do that bad vibrato, but you do it for 7 beats, you do it with a rhythm, and you keep coming at it, is eventually you learn to relax. And eventually you loosen up, because a lot of what's going on is that we're tightening up. Relaxation, big important point in meditation, but an important point in harmonica playing. So here's how I used to, this is what I sounded like when I first started. Now I want one warning here. When you practice this, don't do it for hours at a time. Do it for 5 minutes at a time. I had a student who did it for 3 hours one night, called me the next morning, Adam, I can hardly breathe. The guy had messed up his throat. So don't, 10 minutes a day, 5 minutes a day, but do it every day. Make this just 5 minutes a day, 5 minutes at the beginning and 5 minutes at the end. And what happens is that over time, begins to transform itself into... And if two-hole draw gets sounded pretty good, then I want you to move down to the one-hole. That's the end of this lesson. Next lesson, I'm going to come back and I'm going to talk to you a little bit more about that one-hole and the four-hole and vibrato and tone on those holes. See you next time.